Hello YouTube, this is another video from Super Apple Forever. So today we're going to be looking at the software on the iMac G3. And before I get started, I want to apologize for in case I might be sneezing or coughing or anything. I apologize, I have the flu right now, so I don't feel very well. But anyway, I found a screen recording program. And I know a lot of you have been waiting for the software video for the iMac G3. I know I said it quite a long time ago when I got the actual computer and made the unboxing video. But I just haven't had a lot of time, and I haven't been able to find a screen recording program. But thanks to a YouTuber that referred me to a pretty cool little program called the Snaps Pro X, I can now record video on the iMac G3. So I don't know how to pronounce his YouTube name, but I will put his YouTube username down here or something. But anyway, we're gonna get started now. So I'll show you the specs of the machine, and I want to apologize in advance if it doesn't look so good, or if it's pixelized, or if it's sluggish. As you know, this is a 10-year-old machine, so it's not gonna be the most fast you can expect. But anyway, we're gonna go into about this Mac, and you can see that it is an iMac. It's an iMac G3 Snow, 600 megahertz G3, 512 megabytes of RAM, and with 512 megs, it's extremely fast. Even with that, you can get a lot of things done on here. So we'll go into more info. And now you can see, and by the way, it does have Tiger 10.11, the last version. So you can see all the information down here. And no Bluetooth. It has a DVD drive, which is pretty cool for this machine. FireWire 400. You can see all the graphics stuff down here. It has 16 megs of VRAM, which isn't too bad for a machine from this time. 32-bit. The RAM, you can see 256 megs cards. It has two slots in it. So you can just see all the info down here. No airport card installed. I'm actually using the tethering the internet from my iMac with Ethernet to this computer. But what we're gonna do now is we're going to go look at applications and launch times and things like that. So as you can imagine, this screen recording program is taking a little bit of processing and graphics card power. So these tests may not be as accurate, since I am doing the screen capturing. So we're gonna open up Activity Monitor and see what that is showing right now. As you can see, it took a little bit to open that up, since we have all this stuff open. So you can see it's using almost half the processor, just having these two apps open. You can see the Snaps Pro is the screen capturing program, and it's using quite a bit of memory and system memory. You can see that. So I'll just put that aside, and we'll open up Safari. So this is running, I believe, Safari 4. And for a computer of this age, you can see that it is loading it pretty well. And it might be a little slower because, like I said, I am tethering the internet from my iMac. So we'll look at the new MacBook Pro. While we're doing this, I'll tell you that it does play YouTube. It'll play it in full screen as long as it's in 240p. If you go any higher than that, it'll get extremely sluggish and then eventually crash. But you can see that it loads the full web page with even Safari 4. The full web page is not blocking out any pictures or not showing any JavaScript or anything. It's doing the whole page. The scrolling is a little sluggish though, and again, that's probably because I am using the screen capturing program. Which kind of really isn't fair for it since I am doing that. But we'll go into eBay now. And this is a pretty intensive page. It has a lot of pictures on it, as you can imagine. And I just will click on the iPhone 4. So yeah, it is displaying the web pages pretty well. And that's the web browser, which is Safari. And so let's see what else we can do. We'll open up Transmission. This is a BitTorrent client, and actually I highly recommend this for downloading torrents. It's pretty fast. You can see that I was starting to get a copy of the Snouts Pro X, but none of them are working. But yeah, it does launch it pretty well, and I use this to download torrents a lot because it does take up power on my iMac, like when I'm editing and stuff. But yeah, on here it does download stuff pretty good, and it's got a pretty good size hard drive, 80 gigs for Running Tiger, so there's quite a bit of room for things. But of course, I have file sharing enabled on here, so I can just transfer my things from here to my iMac. My whole goal of this machine is to actually get it to a file server. I want to connect a bunch of external hard drives to it. Of course, I don't have a lot of hard drives right now, so I don't need to do that at this time. But I'm going to be getting some hard drives to use this for as a file server. But you can see that it's running everything pretty well. And that's typical of Transmission to have the quitting thing on it. And it does take a bit to quit. But while it's doing that, we'll open up Calculator. And of course, that's pretty simple. Just your simple calculator. Do 8 times 9 minus 3. And you can see no slacking there or slowing down. But iTunes, of course, we all know iTunes, the media player for Mac. I don't have any songs on here, but we can listen to the internet radio. And the speakers on this computer are really, really good. Of course, you cannot run iTunes 10 on here. You can only run iTunes 8. You can't even run iTunes 9 on here. So I can't do that. But I don't have any music. Of course, I don't need music on here, but you can see that it's iTunes 8 latest version 8.2.1, which I don't think it's fair of Apple to do that to these old computers. They still have a lot of life in them, and they still run great, and I use this almost every day. So we'll go into radio, and we'll just play some music, I guess.
Emda Analog.
I don't want to play it too long because I might get this video copyright problems or something, but you can see it played it very fast. And I don't know if I said this already, but the speakers are great on this computer. I think they're better than the stock speakers in the new iMacs. Or, mine, of course, the early 2008 iMac. They have great bass, and they're actually the speakers that are on the G4 Cube, if you've ever seen those. They sound really good. These are actually made by Harman Kardon, the speakers in this computer. They sound really good. So, yeah. It runs iTunes great. I used to have a iMac G3 from my original computer, or from one of my first Macs when I was like 5. And, I sunk my, iPad, or my iPod to it. And it did great. I think it was like iTunes 6 or something, but it did all of that great. So let's see. iMovie HD. I've done a little bit of editing on here, nothing much, just to see how it plays around with it and stuff. Let's see if we can see what version. And of course, it wants me to upgrade to 11. But again, there is no way to run iTunes 11 on here. It's not even available for the PowerPC, which kind of sucks. 5.0.2 from 2005. I think you can put iLife 06 on here or something, but I just kept it on this earlier version. It's the first version that allows you to edit HD, which I'm not sure how that would go on here, but the graphics card probably couldn't handle it, but you can see that it does it pretty fast. So this is quite different from any new version of iMovie, but some people say they like it better. I've gotten used to iMovie 11 in 08, or what is it? I think it's iMovie 09. I'm not sure. I have iMovie 11, and I've gotten very used to that. I don't use this very often. I have this on my iBook, and occasionally I will edit some stuff on my iBook. I think I've only edited one video on my iBook, or no, I think I've edited like two of them for YouTube, but it works pretty good on these old PowerPC machines. Of course, you really don't want to edit HD unless you have like a 1.3 gigahertz processor or something. But yeah, they'd actually display how much you have available back then because the hard drives were so small, like with the second generation iMac and stuff. They were just, they had really small hard drives in them. And it's kind of, this is, I think, an upgraded hard drive. I think this originally came with a 20 gig or 30 gig hard drive, which is really nothing now. But, yeah, it does edit video pretty well. You can do, like, transitions and stuff. And if you really know what you can do, it'll look just as good as if you edited something on Final Cut Pro. You can run a pretty old version of Final Cut Pro on here, and it does work pretty good from what I've heard. But yeah, we'll open up Disk Utility now. And you can see that it did launch that pretty fast again. It'll show the info excuse me, on your hard drive. And this is a great program for like burning stuff and things like that. So now we'll get into the harder stuff for the computer. I'll open up iWork if I can find it. I'm not sure if I actually installed it on here. No, I didn't. You can actually run iWork on here. You have to install it on a new are a newer that meets the system requirements. You have to install it first on a system that meets the requirements. Then what you do is you can, like, with file sharing, you can go into your computer that you've installed it on and then drag it to your hard drive or your applications folder on the on this iMac, and then it'll copy it there, and then you can be able to actually launch the program. In no way does Office 2008 show that it can run on the PowerPC G3. You have to have the system requirements for Office 2008 is a PowerPC G4 that's at least 500 megahertz, and yeah, so this actually meets that. It has a 600 megahertz processor, of course not the G4 processor, and it also requires 256 megs of RAM. This has 512 megs, so this really does meet the requirements except for the actual processor. So that's, I guess, the reason why you can do that. I guess the program doesn't look for specs every time you open it, but I'm running iWork 09 on my G4 Cube at 450 megahertz, and Office 08 on a 450 megahertz machine, which is pretty cool. But yeah, we'll open up Word 08, and it, like I said, it really isn't designed to run on here, so it's gonna be really, really slow. But even when I had 08 on my brand new iMac, it ran extremely slow too. So I don't have really anything good to say about Office 08. I think the improved Office 09, or I'm sorry, Office 2011 is great. I like it 100,000 times more than this version, and especially Office 04. I didn't like any of the Office versions until 2011, which is greatly improved. But you can see automatically when you open it, and this is with every computer that you install it on, you don't get... it's automatically not straight. You get like this line down here, and you have to manually resize it, which I'm not going to waste time on it. But yeah, so you can see it's just your basic word processor. I can type in something. And a little bit of lag, but not too bad. I guess we'll try and go and do some, let's see, we can do some clip art, if I can find it. Let me see. Sorry about this, I haven't used this version in a while, so not exactly sure on how to do this. But you can see that I clicked on the toolbox, and it took a while to bring it up. Let's see if I can figure out how to insert a picture. Okay, so here's clip art, I think. And of course with this hard drive it will take a little bit to load all these things. So we'll just drag a picture of a CD in here. And I've already clicked it and dragged it, and you're going to see it does take a while to bring up the picture. And there you go. Okay, so I'll exit out of this, and I'll click this, right-click on it. Text wrapping and make it tight. And you can see that this really is a great computer from, like, maybe a child or something. That's uses a computer for school, because it does run this pretty well. Not great, but it does run it, and I'm sure it would run it a lot better without the screen capturing program again. But yeah, I think that these older iMacs and stuff are great computers for children, or younger children that just want to play around with a computer or something. They're great for that. So you can see that when I drag it, it takes a while to get there. I can resize it and make it smaller. So yeah, yeah. So it does all this stuff pretty good. We'll go into WordArt, and we'll do some of that, I guess. So you can see that it is quite sluggish to load these. But we'll do this. We'll just make up something. I'm not sure how to edit this. Okay. I'll just type in my username. And drag that over here. So you can see that it does all of this very well. I haven't tried any charts or any stuff like that, but I'm sure it could handle it. So yeah, just simple stuff like this it can handle very well, and then of course you can save it or print it or whatever you want to do. And I'll just change the size of the text here. I'll make it like 20, I guess. Move this out of the way. Okay. So this really isn't typical of this computer. The screen capturing program is really slowing it down. But and this the word too. We can go in Arial and make it Arial, and then bold and underlined, and then in centered. Okay, so you can see that it does all this stuff, like this easy, typical stuff, very well. So we'll just quit Word, and then we don't want to save. I'm not going to go into PowerPoint because that would probably slow it down, and everybody really knows how PowerPoint works. So we'll open up the original browser that came with this computer, Internet Explorer. Or actually, I don't think that this is the original browser. I think it came with Safari 2. I know that Panther came with 1 or something. Panther had, Panther had Internet Explorer on it, but you had a choice of Internet Explorer or Safari. Internet Explorer was not included with macOS 10 Tiger. You had to download it separately if you wanted it. But you can see, like, this is a 6-year-old browser. We can go to about Internet Explorer. It's 5 or 7. No, it's 9 years old. So yeah, you're not going to be able to get a lot done with a 9-year-old browser. It runs a little bit faster on the G3 than Safari does, but of course you aren't going to get any modern animation or anything like that. Of course, it can handle like little websites like Wikipedia. It can handle text very well. It can, of course, print. I've printed stuff off of IE before. So it'll load like things like this. And this is the old version of Google. It's loading it like this on purpose. I know that this looks a little different. You get kind of the macOS 9 look with these buttons and stuff. And a cool thing though that I really like about this is that you can customize the color. I need to see how to do that. It's here. Okay, here you can change it to like basically all the colors of all the early iMacs and things. You can have it like the ruby red of the ruby iMac, and that's just, I think that's really cool that you can do that. Aqua blue. Let's see if Bondi Blue is here for the original iMac. Yeah, Bandai. So the color of the original iMac, and then grape for the grape iMac. And let's see. PowerBook black for the old PowerBooks. So I'm going to keep it at black because I think that looks pretty cool. So yeah, you can see how it looks. It loads these pages pretty well. I can go into images. And it loads them a lot faster than it would with Safari. But again, you can already tell how this looks like without Safari. It does display the old version of Google and all of that. So I'll just click this image and see full size. Hopefully it'll load it. So no. This is either a message from my iMac or a message from Internet Explorer. That bandwidth limit exceeded. You can see that the computer can still be put to a lot of good uses. Of course, you can always check your email on it, do a little bit of word processing and internet browsing. So, if you have any questions, please feel free to ask me in the comments or in a private message. Either one's fine. And also, please don't forget to like and subscribe. And thanks for watching.